I've always wanted a way to quickly make eyelashes for my character in Blender. And recently, with the help of geometry nodes, I think I have found it. This way, I will have highly customizable eyelashes, with many possibilities, that I can modify to my liking, thanks again, to geometry nodes. Disclaimer. This method is hugely inspired by Nazar's method of making eyelashes, as shown in his video. In the description, I've included a link to his video, and links where you can purchase his eyelash pack. Downloading. Before we get started, you need to download the eyelashes first. You can get the blend file for free on my Gumroad or my ArtStation, links in the description. This eyelash will only work for Blender version 3.1 or above. If you use previous versions of Blender, it will not work as expected, because there are major features differences. Opening the blend file. Now that you have downloaded it, you can open the blend file to see what's inside. There will be one parent collection named EYL_geonodes, which contains two more collections dividing up the upper and the lower eyelashes. Note that I only included the left eyelashes because it is easier to set up, and it is going to be easier to use, as you only need to place it only on the left eye, and mirror it using mirror modifier later. But if you for some reason like to have it for the right eye, you can just flip the eyelashes parent empty, by scaling it on the x-axis by -1, or, by going to object then go to mirror and select either x-global, or x-local, depends on your situation. Or, if you like to have them both for the left and right eyes, duplicate the parent collection, and then flip the parent empty in that duplicated collection, with the steps I've just mentioned. Appending. And now that we get that out of the way, we can start placing the eyelashes to the character. That can be done by appending the collection to the file you are working on. Do that by going to File, then click Append, and then go to the directory where you've placed the downloaded blend file, double-click on that, then go into Collection and select the eyelashes collection, EYL_geonodes, then, click Append. In Blender version 3.2, you can mark the collection as asset, so you can use it with Blender's new asset browser later. Placing the eyelashes. Placing the eyelashes is very simple, like editing a curve as usual. Because the eyelashes use curve to control the shape, using Curve Deform Modifier. The nice thing about Curve Modifier is that, the control curves tilt, control plus T, and radius, alt, plus S, will also tilt and scale the object that is being deformed. Now, select the parent empty and move it close to the eye, then select the control curve, then go to the edit mode, then start shaping the curve to match the shape of the character's eye. Modifying the look of the eyelashes. Select the eyelash objects, and go to Modifier Properties, there will be settings I've prepared. These settings are the most essential to modify the look of the eyelashes, and we will go through every single one of them one by one. I have divided the settings into different sections, and the first one is going to be geometry. Starting from the top, we have upper slash lower setting. This setting will flip the eyelashes up and down, to make it appear as the upper eyelash, or the lower one. The next one is similar, but it will do it left and right instead. This can also be another additional way to flip the eyelashes as I have explained earlier. Overall seed. This one will randomize the overall look of the eyelash. This controls random tilting, random size, and random crossing all at once, of which we will be going through each of them later on. The next section is strands. Strand count. This one is pretty self-explanatory. This adjusts how many strands of the eyelash will have in one object. Strand resolution. You will see the change better if you enable the wireframe overlay. This one is to control how many loop the strand will have along itself. Quick notes. I added the next three settings after I recorded all other footages. So, it might be missing in some parts of the video. But it will be in the final blend file. And the other settings will still work properly as expected. Okay, let's continue. For the strands, we have three different options. 1. Using default curve that I have provided in the node tree. 2. Using a custom object. Or 3. Using a collection with multiple objects inside of it to be instanced together. The next three settings are related to each other. Default slash object slash collection strand. This one is a switch between using default, or an object, or a collection for the strands. Custom strand object. This one is to select which curve object that will be used as the custom strand. Custom strand collection. This one is to select a collection that contains multiple objects to be used as the strands. This means, all the objects in that collection will be used as the strands, as opposed to the custom strand object, which only uses one object. Now we are in the bevel section. For the bevel, I have provided a default shape as the bevel in the node tree just like the strands. Which you can switch to using a custom one as well. Bevel resolution. Again, you will see the change better if you enable the wireframe overlay. This adjusts how many edges will go around the strands. Default bevel radius. This adjusts how thick the strands will look. This setting doesn't affect the tapering of the bevel, which we will be looking at later. Default slash custom bevel, and custom bevel object. These two settings are related to each other. The default slash custom bevel will switch between using the default bevel or a custom one. While the custom bevel object will select which curve object will be used as the custom bevel. Now, let's move on to the placement settings. Tightening. This one is to tighten, or even loosen, the strands to one another. The higher the value, the tighter the strands will be. To tighten, it will go as high as 1. To loosen, it will go to negative value, and will go as far as you want it to be. Offset. This one is to move the eyelash on its local x-axis. And with the curve modifier enabled, it would look like as if it moves along the control curve. Enough with placement, now let's get to random tilting. Tilt A and Tilt B. Each of these settings will adjust the tilting of half of the eyelash's strands. If you are going after eyelash style with no random tilting, then keep the number of these settings the same. Tilt C. After adjusting the tilting, now you can randomize it, without affecting other settings, like the random size, and random crossing. After tilting, we have random size. Size A, and size B. Similar to the tilting, these two will adjust the size instead. Generally, you would want to make the eyelashes strands to have random size. But if you are going after eyelash style that have the same size all over the strands, then of course, make them the same number. Size seed. Also similar to tilt seed, this setting will randomize the size that you have adjusted, without affecting other settings, like the random tilting, and random crossing. Done with size, now we move on to random crossing. Crossing A, and crossing B. Still similar to random tilting and random size, this one will help to cross the strands to one another, by making one of them higher number than the other one. But there will be cases where you don't need them to cross. Then make the settings the same number. Crossing seed. After adjusting the crossing, now you can randomize it, without affecting other settings, like random tilting, and random size. I need to mention that, all the seed settings above, will not work if you have the A, and B settings, the same number. The reason why I added these different seed settings, is because, if you, for example, liked how the random size and random tilt look, but not happy about the random crossing, you can just change the random crossing seed, without affecting the other two settings. After all the random settings, now we have spread settings. Spread A, and spread B. These two settings spread the eyelash outward, the spread A will spread the inner parts of the eyelash, while the spread B will spread the outer parts. For the T-shading section, we will cover that later on the video when we talk about material, further adjustments. In this part of the video, we will be going through settings inside the node tree, that couldn't be exposed to the modifier properties, like any other settings that I've prepared. These settings come in the form of float curve nodes, strand shape. You can find this node, by looking for node with the color red, or you can search the node by pressing Ctrl plus F, and then type, strand shape. This node will simply modify the shape of the default strands. Scale gradient. Find this node, by looking for node, with the color green. This node, will adjust the transition of the size, that goes along the local x-axis of the eyelash, or along the control curve, if you have the curve modifier enabled. Bevel tapering. Find this node, by looking for node, with the color blue. This node, will adjust the tapering of the bevel. This node will still be functional even if you use a custom bevel object. The shading. For the shading, I've provided one material for the eyelashes. In the material, I've prepared a node group, named EYL_attributes, which contains three attribute nodes. These three attributes, have been captured from the geometrynodes system. Random per strand. This socket, will give random input to build the material. You can change the seed of this socket by going to the eyelashes modifier properties. In the T-shader section, there is a random per strand material setting. Here, you can randomize the result of that socket. Strand length. This socket will give out value, from 0 to 1, along each strand. Example use of this, would be when you want to make color gradient along the strands as shown here. Curve UV. This socket will give out UV map, similar to curve object. Technically, the strands are just a curve that has been instanced along another curve. If you add separate XYZ node, and preview the X-axis, it will basically be the same value as the strand length socket. In the material, I've built a simple material to show how you can use those sockets to build your own material. Don't forget, if you want to apply your own material, select the eyelash object, and go to the geometry node editor, and look for the set material node, or the one with the color yellow, and then select your material. If you've decided to add your own material, you can still add that EYL_attributes node group back, as long as it is still marked as fake user.